the government, as you know, has posted a $10.5 billion deficit, the largest ever recorded in New Zealand history. It'll take years to recover. So what does that mean for the country's future and for everyday New Zealanders? Well, joining us now is financial expert Bernard Hickey. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
It's such a big number that is actually so hard for, I guess, most households out there to even get their head around what that means.
Well, what it means is that the government is now borrowing $250 million a week, which is the same as what you spend on a hospital, a small enough hospital. So every week we aim to go overseas and borrow the size of a hospital just to keep the government going. This is a very serious problem for New Zealand over the next decade. We're not going to be in surplus for almost a decade, and it means that by the time we get out of it, when we've got all these baby boomers retiring and going to the hospital, we're going to have a big debt that we have to deal with. It's now time, I think, for the government, and Bill English is making the right noises, but also we need to see John Key come out and say some tough stuff, frankly. He's a nice guy, he comes out and he says friendly stuff, but he needs to come out and say we need reform for this economy if we're going to be sustainable. Because frankly, the way we're living through our government is not sustainable. We're going to have to reduce the amount we spend on healthcare, on education, on pensions, on many of the things we've taken for granted. This means, in some way, we're going to have to reduce our standards of living. This is something that will not be something that the government will want to tell, but I can
see... This is the reality.
Paul's looking fairly frightened over there.
Well, it's his retirement you're talking about.
That's right. And that's something that the government needs to actually get across to New Zealanders. We're in a very serious situation. We need reform, long-term reform, if we're going to make this sustainable.
So basically, as you say, the way we live will change. I mean, the hospital was a good analogy, because if they are borrowing this money and we can't do things like build new hospitals, we will be suffering in those areas. Will we be having to pay more out of our own pockets?
Well, that's the question the government will have to ask over the next couple of years. Do we have more user pays in health? Do we have more user pays in education? Do we reduce the size of the pension? Do we lengthen the retirement age? These are questions the government should be asking and should be providing answers for us and providing some sort of vision about how it's going to be done, because we need to restructure the economy itself as well as the government to be able to make this sustainable. I'm just not hearing those signals out of John Key. He's the guy who says talk to the hand all the time whenever you talk about reform. He needs to actually talk about getting the economy back on some sort of sustainable track so that we can support this deficit we've got planned.
Bill English didn't seem to have rose-tinted glasses on when he was talking yesterday.
No, he's much closer to those numbers and I think is much more aware of the gravity of the situation. Maybe John Key is in private and he likes to talk things up in public. It's now actually time to come out in public and say we need reform of not just the government, but the entire economy. He has sky-high poll ratings. Everyone loves him, apparently. So why doesn't he use that political capital to actually talk about reform? I haven't heard it yet.
What can people do? I mean, this is not something that it directly impacts on people today, just because a figure comes out yesterday. I mean, is there anything we can do or be prepared for change?
Well, we should be ready for change and starting to participate in the debate. I mean, what do we want our government to look like in this new environment? Mm. What do we want our tax system to look like? Should we be bringing in, for example, new taxes? Because this is what this means. We're going to have some new taxes. There's going to be some pain for some people. Maybe it's a land tax or a capital gains tax, something like that. Because unless we do that, the budget will continue to get out of control, the debts will increase, and we in 10 years' time will be in a position we have to make some really tough decisions.
Mm. In 12 months we went from a $2.3 billion surplus to a $10.5 billion deficit. Obviously we're all talking about the recession. Is that solely responsible for that massive turnaround?
There's a combination of things. Yes, the recession has increased unemployment, it's reduced corporate tax revenues and reduced the amount of money we're getting from some people's incomes. But the real problem is that there was a spending spree in the last couple of years of the Labor government, which has come through. There were some tax cuts, corporate tax cuts, and also there's some big holes in the tax base. You know, the property investors in New Zealand don't pay $700 million worth of tax. They make losses. Farmers deliberately make losses so they don't have to pay tax. Mm. Most of the tax revenue is now coming from middle to upper New Zealand. We're talking the sort of 70K to 120K mark. Because people below that, particularly if they have families, are not paying tax because they're getting working for families. It's an issue we need to broaden and strengthen our tax base.
Mm, I suspect that there's quite a bit on this on your website as well, Bernard, which of course is interest.co.nz. Thank you for joining us this morning, Bernard Hickey.